afternoon, students. Today we will discuss the topic that is prickly heat and body odor. As the name signifies that these are the common topic, but these problems generally give arises to the major problems also. So prickly heat is also called the miliaria rubra, and basically it is also known as heat rash. And this is a rash condition that causes the skin to turn red along with the warm stinging or prickly sensation. This feeling is usually accompanied by red dots in the affected area, and these rashes, they may be turned into bumps and blisters, and also that is due to the inflammation. So skin creases, and due to the tight clothing, the air cannot circulate, and they generally give arises to the prickly heat conditions. This is the normal structure of the skin. Skin is generally divided into three layers, that is epidermis, middle layer is dermis, and the innermost layer is the subdermal and hypodermal or hypodermal layer. So epidermis is the outer layer. It is further subdivided into five layers, that is stratum corneum, stratum granulosum, stratum malpighium, stratum lucidum, stratum spinosum. And dermis is generally having the sweat glands, blood vessels, oil glands, nerve endings, and all these things. And the innermost layer, that is the hypodermal layer, these are having the majorly the adipose tissues, those are fatty tissues. So this is the normal structure of the skin. Let's move ahead. So the skin, as we all know, that skin acts as the defense mechanism. Skin plays a major role in the defense mechanism of the body. They generally prevent or act as a barrier against many intruders, that is infection, chemicals, and UV light, UV rays, from invading or damaging the body. They also play an important role in the body temperature control. So by the help of sweating and allowing the sweat to perspirate or evaporate, the body temperature is regulated. But in this condition, in prickly heat condition, the sweat from the gland, they reaches to the surface of the skin through a duct. But in prickly heat condition, that duct becomes clogged, there is a blockage in the duct. So sweat does not come to the surface of the skin, does not secrete from the skin to the surface, and they cannot evaporate, and due to which they trapped beneath the skin surface and cause a mild inflammation or the rash conditions. So basically the symptoms are blisters, patches on the skin, inflammation, and there is also the infectious condition, and mainly red rashes arises in the body. There are some substances, some conditions which triggers this condition. The most important one is the heat condition. You can see that majorly in the summer condition, this prickly heat problem arises due to humidity, due to harder time for the sweat to evaporate off the skin. And prickly heat is common in the people from cooler climate who travel to the warmer climate. Some medications taken for Parkinson's disease, they also block the sweat. Tranquilizers, diuretics, they also change the fluid balance in the body, which can trigger the symptoms of the prickly heat. And dermatologists noted that prickly heat develops basically when there is the infection of bacteria, that is Staphylococcus. Staphylococcus is a normal, but the biofilm they produce, they block the sweat duct and contribute to the skin condition. So person, those are having the Staphylococcus infection, they are more prone to the prickly heat conditions. Basically, the treatment used for prickly heat conditions are, we can use the calamine lotion, which is a protective agent. We can also use the topical steroids, and hydroxylanolin can be used. And during such conditions, basically in summer, you can use or wear the loose clothes. So avoid the skin products which contain the greasy substances like petroleum or mineral oils. And the best way to remove this prickly heat conditions is that to keep yourself away from the irritant substance and make sure that the sweat or the bad clothing right away after experiencing the intense heat. So you can do you can follow these conditions to make your yourself away from this heat rash condition. Camphor and menthol, as we can see that in market, there are basically the deodorizing formulations or antipruritic powders are there, which they generally carry the camphor and menthol in their composition, because camphor and menthol, they give a cooling sensation. When you spread these powders or lotions in your body, they just evaporate and give you the cooling sensation. So they are the good prices, and they also reduce the itchiness. Antihistamines and medications, they can also reduce the itching problem. And they are the basically in, when we talk about the antihistamines, so the best choice is the cetirizine. So you can use the cetirizine or receptor inhibitors, H2 receptor inhibitors, which can reduce the problem of itching, sensitivity, hypersensitivity, or other allergic reactions. So these are the general. This is the general. Information about the prickly heat. In next class, we will discuss some another topic. And I stop my lecture here only. In next class, we will discuss the next topic. And thank you.